This Civic Media podcast is sponsored by UW Organ and Tissue Donation. Organ donations are desperately needed, and now is the right time to become an organ donor. Talk to your family. Get the dot. Save lives. Go to heroicdeed.com.
WMDX. John and Gordy in the morning.
Good morning.
And a good morning to everyone out there. We're overlooking State Street. Looks real nice, dry. We're a block away from the capital city of Madison, broadcasting live each and every morning right here on this station. Not across the state, but right here in Madison.
Where the action is.
That's right.
Look at the traffic this morning, John. It's all backed up. Happy November. It's November. Hey.
Well, yeah. Yeah, this is the first day of November. Halloween is, I don't know.
It's
you, did you go out for Halloween at all?
I did. I was out and about last night.
Was that a Halloween party?
It was, no, yes. There were people all dressed up in their costumes.
What were you dressed up?
Yeah.
I wore my same Scooby outfit that I had on at the night market.
Oh, that's getting a workout
that
this
works.
Year.
Yep. Yeah. You
people
get,
love that
get
costume.
Done.
Yeah, they do.
Well, the dumbest costume I ever wore was the cow costume. I still regret wearing that. With the udder in the front. As suggestive as it is, I feel embarrassed to have done that.
Did anyone like
pull any of my
over my teeth?
No, isn't that sad?
Well, it is a good-looking start this morning. It's chilly out there, though.
It is. Very cold.
37 degrees, but it feels like the feels-like temperature, you know, what it feels like on your exposed skin. It feels like 31.
Because the wind chill doesn't exist anymore, right?
Right. Yeah, it doesn't exist.
This is really
Forget
sad.
About it.
We're going to spend 10 minutes just describing how we feel about it instead of just saying the wind chill is.
I know. What do you think the afternoon high will be?
I don't know, but my temperature said 33 degrees this morning.
Did it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Out in Middleton.
All right. Well, Middleton, so, you know.
It's colder
it's
out there.
It's a little colder.
We're brutally cold out there.
What do you think the high temperature should be today? How do you want to guess?
I think it's about 47 degrees.
Okay. Well, let's get the balls out. Let's do the
lottery
balls.
Let's get our balls out. Boy, every morning it gets colder and colder. Taking the balls out is getting more difficult.
First number is 4. The second number is 8. 48 for a high today. That's it.
A lot of sunshine.
A lot of sunshine.
Was that
you
close?
You said 47.
So
you were right there. Yeah. I mean, that's, you know.
Yeah.
The 1 degree guarantee or whatever. That stupid thing is.
I don't know if Catherine is listening at this point.
Well,
I know that she probably jumped out of her skin when I started talking about balls again.
Here we go.
But we do have the John and Gordy balls, right? The stress balls.
Yeah, we got a whole box of them.
Put our names on.
We did throw them off the roof the other day, and
nobody
returned them. We were saying if they returned them, they get a free T-shirt, but I think they just ignored them, let them roll down the street, I guess.
Yeah.
I think 2 or 3 of them got caught in the street sweeper. There was a problem.
We jammed it up, man.
Yeah, that's all right.
Burned up their belts.
City can take care of
it. That's all fine.
That's good. Yep. Yeah. So 9 minutes past the hour. It's Friday. Yeah. We've got a rocker in the studio.
I'm still working on getting a John and Gordy ornament.
An ornament?
Yeah.
For Christmas.
Christmas
tree? Well, couldn't we just use the
right
stress balls?
Well,
put a little hook on them and there they...
Yeah.
There
put a hook on it, and you've got our balls to look at when you're sitting there in front of the fireplace.
Do we need to pair them up so then you have one of John's balls and then one of Gordy's balls?
Yeah.
Well, we have two colors, red balls and blue balls.
I'll be the red, and you can be.
Okay. All right. Oh, God.
Here we go.
Let's move on from this.
We don't
need to get into it again.
Let's check out.
What's on the National Day calendar today?
Thank you, Sam. Let's do this thing.
Sounds like a good idea. I'm there with it.
Is it or is it not? Hang on. Get my papers here. Is it or is it not National Fountain Pen Day?
Oh, no. Not again. Didn't we just have that? I hate big pens. Okay, let's just go away from this subject.
Jeez. Okay. Is it National Bicycle Awareness Day? Is it National Calzone Day? How about National Cinnamon Day? Is it National Jersey Friday? How about National Brush Day? There's a lot of days today.
Yeah.
National Deep Fried Clams Day. National Cook for Your Pets Day.
Can I just, cut you off here? Before you
too
get
many
to the
days?
Fake one.
That's too many days.
Yeah, let's just,
cut it off there.
Yeah.
All right.
So which one's the fake one, John?
There weren't any fake ones. They're all dumb.
Are you sure about
there's
that?
There's a fake one in
there. Is there really? You already did the fake one?
I did.
Okay, it's Big Pens.
No.
Fountain. He didn't even. Yeah, he said fountain pens. because we've been on the air for a year, we're gonna have to start repeating national days.
Oh, see, yeah. That's
short-term
right.
memory loss. This is getting worse and worse. Yeah, fountain pens. I love fountain pens. So,
Sam, do you have a guess?
It's not Bicycle Awareness Day.
You are correct. You get a shiny new dime added to your account. You get your bonus check at the end of
the
year.
Is it really that hard to be aware of bicycles?
Well, there's a lot of them around Madison.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what. Yeah, see them out all over the place. I still have to get my bike fixed. I got to have you come over, Sam, and take a look at it. It's National Fountain Pen Day. Fountain Pen Day. Who has a fountain pen anymore? Well, National Fountain Pen Day. We're celebrating the timeless beauty and functionality of the fountain pen. Join us as enthusiasts around the globe as we embrace the use of fountain pens. I don't even know where you'd buy a fountain pen nowadays. They have them in like a Office Max or
they still have the cartridges.
I was at an art store yesterday. And had a big selection of them. Yeah.
What art store? Where's an art store?
It's right on Gorham. It's
downtown?
Like less than 2 blocks away. Yeah. John, you know the mimeograph I've been working on?
Yes.
You want to smell that ink again?
I love that stuff.
I was looking for ink for the mimeograph yesterday.
And they had it there. No?
No, they didn't. But they had plenty of fountain pens.
But the ink is on a sheet of paper.
Right.
Well,
right.
Okay. Yeah. So did you find a source for that?
No.
Not yet.
Okay.
Well, the fountain pen is used in artwork as well.
That's right. Yeah.
Different points.
Hmm. Very true. Mm-hmm. John just likes to huff ink. That's what he wants me to finish this project for.
I do. And, well, and as a kid, I licked it all off.
Oh, good Lord.
No paper as well. My God.
Probably
loaded with lead.
What? The text is coming in from our program director, station manager.
Yeah. I guess he was listening.
Let's not.
Word that we were saying before that she does not want us to say again.
Say one more time.
Okay.
One more time.
All right. Okay. We acknowledge that statement. Okay. And let's move on.
We probably won't remember it, though.
3 fountain pen facts.
Yes.
Number one, the most expensive fountain pen ever sold was the Montblanc Meistersteck Solitaire Le Grand with a diamond-encrusted nib.
Mm-hmm.
What the hell? Which sold for $73,000 in 2006.
That's chump change.
Yeah, that's nothing.
The largest fountain pen ever made was over 7 feet long and weighed over 200 pounds. Well, that was a little tough to carry around.
Practical.
The most popular type of fountain pen nib is the medium nib, which produces a line that is approximately 0.5 millimeters wide.
Wow, I'm glad we know that.
Well, handwriting, it was good for handwriting because it was so smooth.
On the wall.
Okay. No one does that anymore. No. They print, so they don't need the fountain pen anymore.
Mm. Okay. Let's see what else we got. National Cinnamon Day. You like cinnamon?
Cinnamon's very healthy. I just found out about that.
Okay, let's move on.
What?
National...
Okay.
Well, what?
We don't care about health anymore.
The holiday season warms up with National Cinnamon Day today. Yeah. The spice that ushers in a season being versatile all year long.
They're not even talking about the health, nutritional
part
of it.
Speaking of the change of the seasons, now that Halloween is over, what's your take on, do we just pass by Thanksgiving and go straight to Christmas in terms of festivities and all that?
Yep.
Yeah. I'm not really a fan of Thanksgiving, but.
Yeah. Great turkey dinners, but that's about it.
Okay. It's National Calzone Day today. You like your calzones, John? You're a Italian?
I think calzones are great. It's just that when they make them commercially, it's all crust. There's nothing in them.
You know, the loose translation of the word calzone.
Wow.
The microphone just smacked you in the face.
Yeah. Just I was going to say,
robotic.
You're treating it like a punching bag now?
What happened over there?
I think I got an erection.
The loose translation of the word calzone from Italian to English is trouser legs.
Really?
What?
Just coincidentally.
Oh, my God.
That's what it means.
Is it because it's
Italian.
Like you like hem the dough or something?
The translation may explain the purpose of a calzone, which is essentially a pizza hand pie. However, carrying out the task of eating a calzone while walking on two legs is mighty improbable. I don't know where this is.
Wow.
Never mind.
It's going into dark area.
It's crazy.
I hate to know where it ends up on that.
Okay.
Thing.
It's National Brush Day.
Really? I thought that was the fake one, actually.
Has a picture of a toothbrush, but it's to salute all brushes, hair brushes, you know.
I thought they were talking about a brush being a pile of leaves or something. You know?
No, it actually is for the toothbrush. Okay.
Oh, it is. Okay.
Doing a little more research there. Okay. Let's see. How much time do we have? Are we good? National Cook for Your Pets Day. You know, cook something for your pets. National Deep Fried Clams Day and National Vinegar Day. I didn't get that one. Let's go to the history books. This is
this is
crazy day in the national day calendar.
I'm getting sick of this.
What do we got? What do we got in the history books?
What do we
have? Let's open up the book.
What do we have?
All right, open it.
Oh, it's awful dusty.
so dusty. Goodness gracious.
Johnny, you okay?
Okay. Need to put you on a breathing device or something. Today in 1512, going way back, you remember it like it was yesterday?
Yeah,
sure.
No, I'm sure.
That was a great year.
The Sistine Chapel opens to the public.
Oh, yeah.
The famous Renaissance. I forget the name of the actual work of art on the ceiling painted by...
Michelangelo.
Yes.
Well, that would have been awful, not being able to go in and see it.
Yeah. It took him years to do that.
Well, people didn't know what they were missing out on.
Yeah. Right.
They hadn't seen it yet.
Okay. What else happened?
Are you familiar with the Stamp Act? In colonial America?
I think the British imposed something.
Yes.
Everyone hated it.
Right. Yeah.
You had to pay a tax on basically every printed piece of paper. And what did the colonists not like? Their taxes.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And
about representation.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. Next.
Next. You don't care about this at all, do you?
Yeah, we do.
No, this is very important.
This next one is, really important.
In 1800, on this day, James Madison moved into the White House, the very first president to do so.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah. City of Madison is named after James Madison.
Oh, really?
Oh.
I don't know if you knew that or not.
Well, we got James Madison Park, so I guess that makes sense.
That's an incredible insight.
That's what I'm here for. Okay, we're just getting going on a very first day of November. It's Friday. We'll be back with What's Trending.
Yes.
And a whole lot more on the John and Gordy in the Morning Show.
Absolutely.
You're listening to Civic Media. Stay up to date on the latest news and information for your local community and Wisconsin by signing up for our free email newsletter. Visit civicmedia.us/email to get started.
You can ask me what's trending. What's trending? You can ask me what's trending.
Well, that's a good question. What is trending anyway?
621.
A lot of things are.
Yeah. The weather is trending. 37 degrees this morning, high of just 48. This portion of the John and Gordy Show is brought to you by Verlo Mattress of Madison. Sleep better and dream bigger on a handcrafted Verlo mattress available on Madison's east side and west side or online at verlo.com. Talking about trending, boy, what Trump said, it's... It's always something. Every day now, it just gets crazier and crazier.
It's
just
hard to imagine he
can
top himself each and every day, and then we're forced to cover
to say something about
the stupidity of his comments. And today, it happens to have something to do with 9 barrels or
execution.
A firing squad.
Yeah, an execution.
Yeah.
That's what he's
promoting. Always really something good to talk about.
in your campaign speeches, your rallies.
Yeah. So why don't we play the cut with Trump.
Okay.
Talking about that.
I don't blame him for sticking with his daughter, but his daughter is a very dumb individual, very dumb.
He's talking about Dick Cheney and Liz Cheney.
She's a radical war hawk. Let's put her with a rifle standing there with 9 barrels shooting at her, okay? Let's see how she feels about it. You know, when the guns are trained on her face.
On her face. Wow.
Wow.
I mean, this guy just, he might just sit there and think about dark things all day long.
Yeah. Bloody execution.
Yeah.
9 barrels pointing.
9 barrels.
She had a response to this, too.
Right? Yeah, she did. And that response is, this is how dictators destroy free nations.
Yeah, that's it.
No kidding.
Yeah.
And you got to wonder how he can comfortably say this before the election, thinking that this won't make a difference. People won't really care. They won't hold me accountable for saying something as brutal as this. But he feels comfortable saying it, even before an election, because he knows he can do anything he wants out on Fifth Avenue.
Mm. Well, and he's still using his the assassination attempt, you know, the bloody ear attempt, in his campaign ads. You know, just roll it out there.
Yeah.
You know, fighting for America, standing there for you.
It still seems so staged, so staged. I have such a difficult time with that.
What did Joe Rogan say about it? He like asked to touch his ear or something,
he looked at his ear and he really looked close and could not see any damage, and
not even anything.
Boy, he said, that healed up fast.
Not a little scar.
Oh yeah, he's fast. It doesn't seem real to me. And he never made a big deal about it. He never really talked about it after the event. And then later on, he kind of reminded himself, I should bring this up every once in a while.
Maybe he just forgot
about it. Yeah, maybe he forgot completely about his little scheme because Viktor Orban also staged his own assassination attempt. And he had a meeting with Viktor Orban before he brought this up. So, all these little connectors are there. It's just that, you know, you don't want to be a conspiracy theorist.
Yeah, now I was going to say, now you're starting to sound like a conspiracy theorist. Better put your tinfoil hat on.
Well, you know, I mentioned this before. It's difficult for me to understand. But then again, we had the Secret Service in on this. They investigated it. They have all the proof they need to make it seem like it wasn't staged.
Well, and a person died, you know, in the crowd, and there were people injured.
Well, there are sacrifices made.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, he doesn't care.
He wants to
point 9 barrels at Liz Cheney's face.
Right.
Wow.
Yeah.
This is a story that's hit the fan.
it's really
just overnight. Yeah. My God.
Well, there's still a few more days till the election. We'll see what else he can come up with last minute.
Well, you think this will have an impact? I should talk to my MAGA friend and see what he has to say about something like this.
I was going to ask. So post-election.
Mm-hmm.
Trump loses. His followers are going to keep paying attention to him, obviously. Is the mainstream news, do you think, finally going to stop paying attention to him, even if he keeps going off the rails every day like this? Are we ever going to get a break from him?
No, but at least it won't have consequences after the election. If he loses, who cares? You know, let him go. But, I guess we do have to care because this is going to be going through the courts. And the Supreme Court already has indicated that they're going to side with him almost every issue about election fraud and all that.
And the RNC filed an emergency appeal last night early this morning.
Pennsylvania?
In Pennsylvania, asking Pennsylvania Supreme Court to force counties to reject mail-in ballots with the wrong dates. I mean, they're already starting all these court actions.
This is the scheme.
It's already out there.
Start early.
Just flood the courts, all these spurious, frivolous court actions.
All the people that analyze this say, you know, they should have started earlier. So this year they're starting earlier.
Yeah.
Gee, this isn't a scheme or anything, is it?
Yeah.
All right, in this, the politics girl has made the news again.
Yeah, this is
trending. And she was on a panel, and this one guy was sitting there saying, you know, it's both sides. A lot of things are said.
This was on CNN.
Let's just listen to the conversation. Thank God the politics girl was able to straighten.
Is this what you were listening to this morning?
Yes.
You never sent it to me.
Well, I thought I put it in the folder.
No.
Are you sure? I didn't. God, I could have swore I put it in there.
I don't believe so.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, let's not get to it then.
We'll get to it.
I was going to mention before when we were talking about all the things that people are throwing.
What? It's cut 13.
13?
Yeah, cut 13. It's in there. I'm looking right at it.
Okay.
I don't have a cut 13. Oh, you added it and then you never told me. It's not in here yet. We'll probably get to it a little bit later. Just hang
really?
On, John.
Okay.
But
right.
I wanted
you can't
to
refresh
say,
it. Just refresh it.
No, because I got to load it into this program.
Okay,
just take,
can we
a, take
discuss
a chill
something?
Pill. Yeah, I was going to say, I went out to vote yesterday.
Yeah, how'd that go?
I went to the Madison Central Library, yeah. Like a block down the street. I can
right?
see it from where I'm sitting right yeah. now.
Did you wear your Scooby-Doo?
No, I didn't wear my costume. But I went early. I didn't go on election day like I usually do because I have heard about all
sure.
of these lines, and I didn't want to have to wait in line on election day because I'll be busy working here.
Oh, yeah.
And I still had to wait in line. For over an hour.
Oh, well, no.
And they said it was the shortest line in town. So if you're able to vote early,
yeah.
It's probably going to be even worse than that on Election Day, November 5th. If you're able to vote early, I would advise you to do so.
Oh, definitely.
Okay. Thank you, Sam.
Well, Secret Service is out there saying, you know, look out. There's terrorism going on at the polls.
You voted early, too.
I did, yes.
So did I. Yeah. Okay, 29 past the hour. Right around the corner, Idiocracy.
And then we'll get to the politics, girl.
Okay. It's all coming up. John and Gordy in the morning, 92.7 WMDX. Good morning.
You're an organ donor, right? Well, here's a tragic fact. Approximately 20 people die each day waiting for precious donated organs. You could make a life-saving decision simply by getting that important dot on your driver's license. That little dot shows those who need to know that you've made a decision to donate organs at a critical time. Go to heroicdeed.com to learn more about the importance of organ donation and how you can make your wishes known. Talk to your family. Get the dot. Save lives. HeroicDeed.com.
As the 21st century began, intelligence continued to decline until humanity was incapable of solving even its most basic problems.
What an idiot! Oh, what a loser!
Now listen, Grapehead. I'll explain it so even you can understand it.
Idiocracy.
For the smartest guy in the world, you're pretty dumb sometimes.
Oh, we got some stuff today.
Do we?
Oh, yeah.
It's new month, you know? November is here.
Celebrating November 1st.
It's Friday. It's chilly out there, 37 degrees. Feels like 31 with a little bit of a light breeze. High today, just 48. A lot of sunshine today.
I just want to shout out an Onion headline because we got the new edition of The Onion in yesterday.
Yeah. That's right.
I think you've got it right there next to you, John, but it's... Obama says he's scared that November is coming, not because of the election, because he loves Halloween and he's sad that it has passed. It's right on the front page on the left.
Oh, it is. Oh, yeah. I'm worried about November because Halloween is my favorite holiday and I'm sad and I'm sad when it's over.
He's a very sensitive guy.
He is. Yeah. That's why a lot of people didn't like him, you know? His feelings about Halloween just get in the way.
Getting a few texts this morning. You can text us at 608-879-8255 or call us. That's 879-TALK. Here's a text from Doug. Says, now that Trump has promised RFK Jr. to be the head of the nation's health agencies, it begs the question, have you guys been checked for brain worms? That's right. We all have to get checked for brain worms once in a while.
Imagine having somebody in charge of health and human services who claimed he had a brain worm at one time. Oh, my God. This is...
All those agents.
This isn't real.
Not only that, but that it died and then just stayed there years.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Oh, man.
Okay.
Oh, and also in the Onion, rather, it says here, pompous geese... fly in cursive V formation.
That's great.
what the hell?
All right. It's the printed edition of The Onion. We love it.
Yes. Yeah. And in fact, it's not as quite as bizarre as covering this election.
It's almost.
But it's close.
Pretty all close right. to reality.
Well, why don't we get to the politics girl?
Yeah.
She was on a panel, and there was this guy, you know, on both sides, everybody's
on CNN,
doing
yeah.
it. And he's saying, you know, a lot of people are saying bad things on both sides. And,
right.
And she,
no big
would,
deal.
She wasn't having it. It wasn't something she...
Right.
She believed herself.
This is the fascism argument again,
yeah,
right?
This is the fascist argument. Let's check it out here.
Well, I also want to make a point that Democrats have been calling him a fascist and other names for a long time. There's plenty of blame to go around.
Republicans, too.
Well, hold on a second.
A fascist is not a name. A fascist is a bunch of things that add up to a way of being.
Yeah,
they're calling him a fascist because he's behaving like a fascist.
I agree with that.
Because he's talking about poisoning the blood of the nation, and because he's talking about rounding up political enemies, and because he's acting like a demigod, and because he's saying the rules don't apply to me, and because he's saying I'm going to close up the free press, I'm going to close your schools if you don't do what I say. He's acting like a fascist. That's why we're calling him a fascist. He's saying people are scum because he thinks they're scum, not because they are.
Yes.
Yeah,
well,
drop the mic. Wow.
All right,
that says it all.
That's telling. And that guy still wanted to say something. I don't know what he said afterwards, but I mean, that's the clip that we have. I'm looking at some of the responses to that. One person wrote, "If you talk like a fascist, if you strut like a fascist, you know, he holds his chin up like that.
Right.
If you act like a fascist and you fawn over fascists, chances are you're a fascist." That's,
yes.
And fascist is as fascist does. Or, my Republican friends laughed in 2016 when they said, as a narcissist and a psychopath, he was extremely dangerous to people and the nation. Now he's threatening the life of a woman from one of the most famously Republican families in the country. It's about his sole power and control. And those guardrails that once held those presidents in check are gone now, thanks to the Supreme Court that he put in place.
That's it. Yeah, he's going after Liz Cheney.
Yeah.
And saying she should go before a firing squad.
Yeah.
Face those nine barrels and get her right in the face. I mean,
Can we play that cut again? It is pretty stunning, actually.
It is.
Let's listen to Trump again.
And I don't blame him for sticking with his daughter, but his daughter is a very dumb individual, very dumb. She's a radical war hawk. Let's put her with a rifle standing there with nine barrels shooting at her, okay? Let's see how she feels about it. You know, when the guns are trained on her face.
Jeez. Man.
That's
wow.
Brutal. Beyond brutal.
Again, it's
that's
just
fascist.
It's like those crazy people that just, you know, everything is dark to them. Everything has some kind of violent end to it.
Yeah.
You know, that's how they end every story. With violence, blood, and death, and it seems to make them happy, and they like to see other people cringe while they're telling their story, I guess. Wow. All right. Well, let's correct a few things here.
Okay.
Daniel Dale always is the fact checker at CNN, and he came out against the idea that Kamala was ever a border czar, and the story about inflation. Let's check out what Daniel Dale had to say about both of those issues.
CNN's Daniel Dale has a fact check for us this morning. And Daniel, one place that we know that you are focusing on this morning is what the former president said about Harris and her role in managing the migrant crisis. Let's play this.
Almost 4 years, she never called, not once, the Border Patrol. And she was the border czar. She was in charge of the border. Think of it. 4 years she never called. Now she's trying to say, well, you know, I was really not the border. Whether she was the border czar or not, she was put in charge of the border by Sleepy Joe.
Daniel, what are the facts here?
We've heard this a lot from Trump. You hear it in a lot of Trump ads. It is not true that Vice President Harris was ever the border czar or that she was ever in charge of the border. What Biden actually put her in charge of was a diplomatic effort related to addressing the so-called root causes of migration from three particular Central American countries, Guatemala, Honduras, and El Salvador. Now, that is a, you could say, border-related assignment. It is not being in charge of the border. Homeland Security Secretary Secretary Alejandro Mayorkas has been the official in charge of the border. Now, it is true some media outlets, when Biden gave Harris this assignment in early 2021, incorrectly described her as being having been assigned the job of border czar. But CNN and others have consistently reported she rejected that title. She made clear, and her office made clear, that the assignment was more limited. And that's been the case for almost 4 years now.
I also want to play what Donald Trump said at the rally about inflation. Listen.
You know, we had the best economy, but we had no inflation. Kamala Harris has shattered our middle class. She cast the deciding votes that launched the worst inflation in the history of our country.
How people feel about inflation and affordability is a huge part of this election and how people are voting. What are the facts on this?
This is a classic Trump case where he could just tell the truth and it would be good for him politically, but instead he offers these wild exaggerations. So it is not true that there was no inflation during the Trump presidency. In fact, cumulative total price increases were just shy of 8%, 7.8% over Trump's 4 years. And that includes an abnormally low inflation period when the economy was abnormally slow during the COVID-19 pandemic in 2020. It's also not true that we've had the worst inflation the U.S. has ever had under President Biden and Vice President Harris. Trump could correctly say there was about a 40-year high in June 2022 when the rate increased to 9.1%. But first of all, it's since come way down. It's now 2.4%. Second of all, 9.1 is not even close to the all-time record. We had 23.7% in 1920. Even if you don't want to go that far back, it reached almost 15% in the early 1980s. And so we do not have now and have not had under Biden and Harris record all-time U.S. inflation.
That's right. So inflation was actually rather high during the Trump administration. It only averaged lower only because of the COVID pandemic.
The pandemic, right.
when the economy stopped completely.
Right.
And now everything that they're running on, and I've been seeing this a long time, has reversed itself. Even though public opinion has not reversed itself, we're hoping that somewhere along the way they would notice that it has reversed. The situation has, again, taken a dramatic turn. Gas prices, which aren't controlled by presidents, by the way,
right,
is a metric that's in your face. Consumers believe that, oh, those gas prices, well, it's down. It's down a lot. And the real-time barometer for the cost of living is falling fast, just as millions of Americans head out to the polls. They're under the impression that inflation still exists. Here in Madison, I'm buying gas at Costco for about $2.79 a gallon. That's pretty low.
It's right on. Yeah, it's right around there.
So if you want to shop around, you can get gas at a very low price. All right. But consumers are still hurting. Right. And we know that. And I don't know why we have to always, you know, kind of bring that up every time we talk about how great the economy is. I know everybody feels hurt, but it's always like this. Prices are always going to go up and they're always going to go up around Christmas time. That's the story, except for, you know, Black Fridays and the special deals that they supposedly have. It says here gas prices could be poised to fall even further in the coming days because the oil market is melting down again. U.S. crude plunged 6% this last Monday, and gasoline spending is projected to represent just 2% of real disposable income per capita in October, according to Clearview Energy Partners. And that would be the second lowest October before a presidential election on record going back to 1980. And we're still complaining about the economy and gas prices. Please, please.
Okay, settle down. Okay. Relax, man. You know, you're all uptight about
it. I know. When I start sweating profusely, then you know there's
a problem. I start worrying about you.
Yes, I know. Thanks. Thanks for that.
But thanks, you know, thanks for reminding us gas prices are really pretty reasonable right now.
Yeah.
You know, and it's going to be okay.
It's always better here than it is in, like, California somewhere.
Oh, man. Yeah, they pay outrageous prices.
Oh, they do. Yeah. They do. Yeah. All right, I want to get to something that I think is kind of fun, actually. You know,
really? You have fun? Really?
Well, I know it's a dramatic change from where we were just at, but they're visiting barbershops now instead of diners, right?
Who is? Politicians?
Yeah, no, everybody. Okay. You know, the CNN, yeah. MSNBC, they're going to the barbershops. They
sure.
want to find out what's going on there. They were talking about a female president, and here's a response from a guy. This is 266. Mm-hmm. Let's listen to this.
One topic of conversation has been the idea that some men don't want to vote for a woman president. Do you think that's a factor?
I hear that a lot.
Yeah. What do they say?
Women are too emotional to run the country.
What do you think of that?
What do I think of that? I'm married. You think I'm about to answer that?
Well, what do you say to them?
What do I say to them?
Yeah, when they say that.
I tell them the same thing I told you. I'm married, so. And my wife run my household, so. You know what?
Yeah.
You can run if they run a household like that, they could. I believe they can do it. I just thought about it. I believe a woman could run the presidency. I believe that.
There you
okay.
go. Instantly changed his mind.
Yeah, I bet you he gave a different answer now that he was talking to a woman instead of his barbershop pals.
Possibly. Mm. Okay, now there's another question. Are women too emotional to be presidents? 267, listen.
I've never seen a president tweet so much out of emotions. So to say a female cannot run the country because of emotions, and then the person she's running against stay on Twitter all day reacting because of emotions, doesn't make sense. There are some men that are very much emotional. Their emotions might come out in different ways, anger, rage, but it's still an emotion. If y'all say a woman can't run the country because she's emotional, well, then he can't run the country because he's emotional. And that's all we got. It ain't like we got 10 candidates to pick. We got one and two. So it's you want the emotional female, so to speak, when I say, and I'm quoting it, emotional female since women are emotional, or do you want the emotional male?
There you go. You know, we're going to have to
everybody
go to the barbershops a little bit more often for commentary, because they really know how to nail it.
That's where, all the discussion's taking place.
That is fantastic. Two great observations, right?
Yeah.
Right. Absolutely. Right in the barbershop.
Yep. That's it.
And I should have more of a discussion, I suppose, with my hairstylist next time I come in. Probably knows more than I do.
Well, yeah. I mean, they hear it all, you know?
They do.
People do seem to open up when they're in the barber chair.
They do.
Right?
With the right questions, you know?
Well, yeah.
My mega friend in Milwaukee, he's a hairstylist.
Oh, is
You'd
he?
Think he'd know a little bit more. I think that's why I'm a little surprised at him becoming a cult member, is that he used to have an open mind and talk to his customers and be friendly, and now he's just crazy.
We're back with more of John and Gordy on a Friday morning after this.
You're listening to Civic Media. Find the latest news, information, and archives of all your favorite shows on the Civic Media website, civicmedia.us.
Welcome back. This portion of the John and Gordy Show is brought to you by Verlo Mattress of Madison. Sleep better and dream bigger, or dream better and sleep bigger, or just, you know, sleep till you wake up on a Verlo mattress. A handcrafted Verlo mattress available on Madison's East and West Side, or online at Verlo.com.
Maybe we should get a Verlo mattress for here in the studio.
Oh,
when you came in this morning, I was passed out on the couch.
Yeah,
well, you know, you're a party guy, and I understand that. Halloween, you had your Scooby-Doo outfit on.
I don't know if I'd call myself a party guy, but I got invited to a Halloween party last night, and was out a little late, so.
Well, you could have cuddled with one of the street people. And
it was cold out there.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well.
All right.
Hey, we've got some tickets to give away. Yeah. There's a big show coming to the Overture on Wednesday, November 6th. It's Straight No Chaser. This is kind of a, I don't know, how would you describe this, Sam? It's eight or nine guys. They're dressed up in tuxedos. Yeah. They're all, you know, it's flashy.
You take a cappella and you make it comedy.
Yeah.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a fun show.
And women love this show.
Women do love this show. But, you know, guys love it too.
They do?
I don't know.
Well, maybe you should go and find out.
Yeah.
Give us a report.
These guys are naked, right?
No, they're not naked. It's not that kind of
little what are you talking about?
The formal collar on.
No, it's not like that at all. Will you stop? What is the matter with you? Straight No Chaser, Wednesday, November 6th at the Overture at 7 p.m. If you would like to go, you can text us right now. Our text line is 608-879-8255, or just use the Civic Media app. You can text right in. Let's use the keyword chaser, okay? Chaser is the keyword. If you would like to go to Straight No Chaser, Wednesday, November 6th, 7 p.m. at the Overture, right across the street from the station.
All right. That sounds great. Okay. Fantastic. How you
Chaser is the keyword.
Chaser?
Yeah.
Is the keyword.
Okay.
All right. Are we straight on that?
Straight, no chaser. You got it.
Okay. All right. This is a big story yesterday. I can't believe this is happening.
What happened?
It's more phony outrage. Why would a wife keep her voting choice a secret? Toxic masculinity? Perhaps. Look, Jesse Waters on Fox News melted down just a little bit. So let's get to cut 279 and get his amazing reaction. I wonder what his wife thought when she heard this and when he got home. Let's check this out.
And if I found out Emma was going into the voting booth and pulling the lever for Harris, that's the same thing as having an affair. That to me.
Oh my God. Yeah. Let him finish. Jesse.
That violates the sanctity of our marriage.
Preach on, yes.
What else is she keeping from me?
Exactly.
What else is she lying about?
Why would
Roll
she
the
lie
credits.
To you?
Jesse
Have you threatened her? Why would she lie to you?
Mm-hmm. Oh, they want me to tease.
Why would she do that? And then vote Harris? Why would she say she was voting
He's
Trump?
Not the problem,
and then
so.
Voting
Brain
Harris.
You.
And I caught her. So and then she said, I lied to you for the
so
last four
you admit
years.
Admit you intimidated.
It's over, Emma. That would be D-Day.
There you go.
Wow.
He's a real macho guy.
Oh,
you know,
sure
toxic
is.
Masculinity is the word.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have the second layer to this story with Jesse Waters?
What are you talking about?
Jesse Waters cheated on his first wife.
Oh, is that
oh,
so?
Oh, there
yeah.
it is.
So he has been involved in an affair before, and here he is.
We're
saying about all these consequences that would happen if his wife simply voted for Kamala Harris.
Mm. That's crazy stuff. It really is. But he wasn't the only one who melted down. Charlie Kirk did as well.
What?
Here, let's just play this cut. I was going
to
describe it.
And she needs
it,
people to basically lie to their husbands, which they are promoting, by the way, which I find that entire advertising campaign so repulsive. It is so disastrous. It is just like
I'll show
the
it in a minute.
It is the embodiment of the downfall of the American family. I think it's so gross. I think it's so just nauseating where this wife is wearing wearing the American hat. She's coming in with her sweet husband who probably works his tail off to make sure that she can go, you know, and have a nice life and provide for the family. And then she lies to him saying, oh, yeah, I'm going to vote for Trump. And then she votes for Kamala Harris as her little secret in the voting booth. Kamala Harris and her team believe that there will be millions of women that undermine their husbands. And do so in a way that it's not detectable in the polling.
Wow. So voting the way you want to is undermining your partner in some way, shape, or form. Wow. He works his tail off to make sure that she can have a nice life. And this is how she returns the favor?
Yeah.
My God.
Yeah.
Doesn't he understand what marriage is all about?
Yes. Should vote just like your husband votes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm kind of dealing with the opposite of that right now.
Oh, you are.
My dad refuses to talk to my mom about who he's going to vote for.
Oh.
And that concerns all of us, obviously.
Yes.
And part of me is, like, very thankful that we have a secret ballot system here in the country.
Yeah.
But also, my mom has tasked me with being the one to talk to him and convince him who he should be voting for in this election.
Well, I think you'd be a great person to do that.
Well, thank you. I'm not looking forward to that conversation.
No. Really? Well, don't you have a brother? You have other siblings?
I have a younger brother, yeah.
Okay.
I don't know if...
Can he go with you or no one talk to dad?
No one listens to a younger brother.
We're going to gang up on him.
There you go. Intervention.
Looks like Catherine is intervening.
Did she ever?
Yeah.
You want to respond to
Peterson
that?
Peterson, down deep, you're a dirty old man. Look, I mentioned that maybe the show here... at the Overture Center is nude. And I was only kidding because this is that time of the year. It's everybody knows about deer hunters' wives' parties, right?
Well, sure.
Where they used go out and look at these nude men. Musical.
This is news to me.
You never heard of that?
Wives? No.
Oh yeah.
Really?
Yeah, they have a lot of shows like that.
Yeah.
Up in the Dells, especially too.
So, yeah. So I'm just saying that it's a Wisconsin tradition here.
Okay. We'll be back with more of the John and Gordy Show. Rocker will be in the studio in our next hour right here at 92.7 WMDX. As we were saying, let the sun shine. It's the
John and Gordy Show. The national news cycle never stops, but it can be hard to find news about your local community. Civic Media is dedicated to providing quality local and state news coverage across Wisconsin. With the Civic Media app, you can get notifications about local stories that matter to you and your community. Find the free Civic Media app in your phone's app store and choose notifications from the menu to tell us what kind of news you want to hear about.